Hello YouTube, this is Bowtied Media. Today we've got the middle installment of the 2021 in review, where I'm going to go over the top 50 songs of the year for me personally, my top 50 tracks. They don't need to be necessarily singles, they can be any song that came out this year in 2020, I guess last year in 2021. A few caveats before we go. I'm going to quickly go through probably 50 to number 20, just really quickly because talking about each song individually will be pretty long. Rules that I have is that it's only one song per artist. So one song per artist. So you will not see multiple. You may see multiple if it's like a collab and then like a solo release. So that might be the only time there's multiple. But just one song per artist is the rule. And while this is primarily an EDM focused channel, I listen to a lot of music that is not just EDM. So this list will be a wide variety of stuff. And so that's the rules. And let's get into it. Number 50 is Elio's Typecast, a fun kind of meta track. And 49 is Chet Faker's intro to his album Hotel Surrender with Oh Me, Oh My. 48 is Underscore's Del Mar County Fair 2008, the finale of that LP. 47, Bishu featuring McCall, Hurt Me Too. 46 is the drum and bass banger that is Chameleon's Pure Action. 45, Deadmau5 and Foster the People, Hyperlandia vocal mix. 44 is Son Holo featuring Weezer, Wheels Up, with 43 being Stonemaic, NML, Take Me Away, that fun breaks tracks, breaks track. 42 is G.O.L. Tied Up, which is actually Coucheron and Pasha, the two team up for G.O.L. 41, Feed Me featuring Tasha Baxter, Reckless, fun track there. 40 is S.G. Lewis featuring Nile Rodgers with One More, track that came out early on in this year, fun little disco track. 39, the banger that is Cartel, Boombox Cartel featuring J.I.D. Reaper. 38 is Rufus DeSoul's Alive. 37, Zed's Dead and Elliot Moss, Lost Birds. 36, Tyler, the Creator featuring Youngboy Never Broke Again and Ty Dolla $ign, What's Your Name? That's such a fun short track. 35, Matt Van, Skin and Bones. Love to see Matt Van. He's always a classic. 34, Xavi's Ave Maria. Fun little diss track, apparently, he said on Twitter. It's his only close thing to a diss track he's ever going to make. 33 is the incomparable Glacier with Warriors. 32 is Saint Punk, Empty Bed. Fun little house track there. 31, Ayoban and Nuzb, All of This. Big fan of that track. One of my top Monster Cat songs here. Actually, these all are in order. So if you want to see my old Monster Cat list, you can go back to Monday's release. Speaking of, 30, Cascade and Elevos, Miles to Go. With 29 being K-Flay's Nothing Can Kill Us. Big fan of that track. 28, Crankdat and Ace Aura, The Feeling. Incredible collaboration there. Speaking of collabs, 27 is Fairlane and Grant Hypnotize, with 26 another collab, Silk Sonic's Leave the Door Open. Classic pop track now. 25, Cloud Nun and Mika Martin Flashlight, with 24 being the big collab of Skrillex, Noisia, Josh Pan, and Dylan Brady for Supersonic or My Existence. 23, Just a Gent Aliens. 22, Jeremy Zucker and Chelsea Cutler, This Is How You Fall in Love. 21, Haywire Wisdom. And with that, we are jumping into the top 20. At number 20 is Grabit's Pigs in the Sky. I love kind of Grabit's new direction and where he's going with his music. It's a lot less EDM focused and a lot more like pseudo rock focused, but it has still elements of both. And this is a great example of that kind of fusion of music. 19 is the finale of Dumu with Paralyzed, his final EP out on the Alias, as it's been indefinitely suspended. Dumu went out with a bang with this track, Paralyzed, and upon first listen, it was an instant, even top all-time song for me, but it's up here at number 19. 18, the fun, quick track, the one that I needed more of, Dyro and Conroe, Memory Bank. It's just a fun one that's just so groovy, so funky, so heavy, you just kind of want to play anytime, anywhere, and it puts you in a good mood. 17, Ellis's Orbit, the uncaged version of Orbit and The Taste. This one is a great hit of both nostalgia and powerful grit in a song, and like this electro kind of, not quite dubstep, but just like this grinding feel that is just, it's just fantastic. Number 16 comes with a little bit of a caveat. It is Overwork featuring iKel's Sense. I think the song is only this good when it's paired with bridge. The song beforehand kind of acts as an interlude. Bridge kind of puts pieces one together. It's like a round of a song where it adds something in again and again and again, or at each section, and it just turns into this big awesome track, which kind of then translates or goes into this song sense. So that's why I love it so much, is because bridge exists before it. So I really only listen to the song with bridge beforehand. So this is kind of a 2-for-1. 15 is Inverness featuring Anthony Russo and Kang Daniel, State of Wonder. Oh, this song came out early 2021, and I have been in love with it ever since. It's just kind of those feel-good poppy or dance pop kind of track. There's not a whole ton going on, I'm not gonna lie, but it's just one that I just always have on repeat, always puts in a good move. It's just super uplifting song. And bringing it all the way down to 14, we've got Kings of Leon, 100,000 People. A song I like to put on early in the morning, actually, when I first get up. It's very calming and has a kind of serene atmosphere to it, and builds into something that's a little bit bigger, not a crazy big like chorus section, but something that has a little more oomph and more of a grandiose feel to it in the back half of the song. It's a longer one too, so it's a nice kind of calm one to start your day with, and so that's why it's here at 14. 13, Drinks on Me. More to Give, my number 2 Monster Cat song of the year, is number 13 of all time. This is classic UK garage in terms of my personal preference for the genre. If someone asked, why do you like UK garage, or what's like the song that makes you love that kind of trip hop, trip chill genre, this is it. I think it's fantastic. The vocal chops are amazing, and it's like, what, 3.5 minutes? It hits where it needs to and then doesn't stay too long, and I'm a big fan. Number 12, Swedish House Mafia, It Gets Better. I actually liked Lifetime when it first came out a little bit more than It Gets Better, but I've since come to really, really love It Gets Better. It feels like more EDM-centric or EDM-focused of the three tracks, that being Moth to a Flame as well. I guess Symphony is technically the fourth. But this one, it goes hard. I love that it's kind of a really open, like amphitheater kind of sound at the beginning, and then hits hard with the bass right in on like the third bar, and just like, oh my gosh, you're just like about to lose your mind. It is wonderful. At number 11 is Billie Eilish's Happier Than Ever, a song that really embodies my love for a grandiose song that starts really, really calm and ends with this like explosion of music, this like symphonic sound. This is pretty much that wrapped up in a single track. I love Billie's vocals, and the production from Phineas is top notch on this. Before we get into the top 10, I want to give a few honorable mentions. These are songs that I think potentially may have made the top 10 if I didn't have the one song per artist rule. And so the artists that I'm about to say are artists that will be in the top 10. And so this is a little bit of a, can you guess what it's going to be before it comes out? So here are your honorable mentions in alphabetical order by artist. Bo Burnham's Welcome to the Internet. James Blake, Frozen, feat. J.I.D. and Suave. James Blake, also, If I'm Insecure. Memba, It Always Ends Where It Begins. Porter Robinson's Blossom, Porter Robinson's Look at the Sky. Tristam's Ruthless, and Tristam's Take a Chance. So those artists are going to be in the top 10. We'll go there now. Number 10, Grant and Run, Fix It. I am a huge Grant stan. I love him to death. Everything he does is just pure bliss for me. It is my perfect, like, if I could make future bass, just like if someone could take my music preferences and put them into like some machine, some AI, and it like learned how to make a bow-tied future bass song, one that he would love, it's literally Grant every time. And Fix It is no exception to that rule. It's classic Grant. It's nothing more grandiose or like Constellations or Wishes was, but I still love this track. And Grant's vocal, or Run's vocals, are great too, so big ups. Number 9 is Memba featuring Ricky James, Opposites Attract, from the Phases Project. I did not expect to like this one as much as I did, but I just found myself playing it over and over and over and over and over again. It's just got a nice kind of powerful hook that comes in and keeps you enticed, and it is pretty quick too, and so it's one that once it's done, I'm like, oh, I want to play it again. I instantly want to play it again. I need more of it. So that's why Memba's here at number 9. Number 8, Kanye West, Heaven, Hell. I was a pretty big fan of the Donda album, and nothing, no song really stood out to me other than this track in particular. It feels like a kind of, I don't want to say ripoff, or ripoff's not the right word, but like a lost track from the Kids See Ghosts album. It is just like, whoo, it's powerful. It goes in hard. And I love the sample that they used from, I can't remember who it was, but for the big like drop kind of grandiose section. I keep using the same words, but it's because the same descriptors for all these songs. Heaven and Hell is a banger of a rap track, and you should go listen to it if you haven't. Number 7 is the song I think the least amount of you will actually know watching this video is Mitchell, I think, or Michael, I'm not actually sure how to say it, but Holidays. He's kind of this more indie trip chill, like I said from a little before, kind of has that more underground feel to it. But Holidays is a really bright and uplifting song that talks about turning your weekdays into holidays. It's super fun and it's an earworm for sure. Number 6 is Bo Burnham's Goodbye. This song is only as incredible because of what was leading up to it. This is the finale, technically the finale of the album, the Inside the Songs and the whole Netflix special. And oh, it's only as good because you listen through the whole album and then you get to this song and it just encapsulates everything into one short, like 4-minute track. And it's just a great representation of the whole thing that Bo Burnham was trying to go for, his whole comedic journey, I should say, and struggle and mental health journey in the whole thing. And so it's a fantastic listen, and it's only really as good as it is because of the lead up that was up to the song. Number 5, Churches featuring Robert Smith with How Not to Drown. This song I had on repeat. I mean, most of these songs I've had on repeat for freaking forever. It's a longer song with the ending that kind of overstays its welcome just a little bit. But I've been a fan of the kind of synth poppy band that is Churches for quite some time. They're not an actual like Christian group, despite their name being Churches. But they are super fun to listen to. It's super uplifting, and Robert Smith gives a great vocal feature. Number 4 is the 10-minute journey that is Coldplay's Color Atura. I don't know why I said it like that, but I did. The whole album I thought was pretty meh, but only was good because of this individual track. Color Atura is incredible. Takes you on the space journey through the cosmos. I love Chris Martin's vocals. They just add so much to every track. And this really felt like one of the best Coldplay songs I think I've heard in the last decade. Number 3, James Blake, Life Is Not the Same, the second single that came off of his Friends That Will Break Your Heart LP. Another one that is kind of, I'm not sure most of you will actually know who this is, but I encourage you, please go listen to James Blake. Especially a lot of my viewers are EDM focused people. It's sort of EDM, it's like pseudo, it's more poppy, but has the EDM influence. Life Is Not the Same is incredible. His vocal performance is top notch. He's probably one of the best singers out there, I would say, that does this kind of music. He's a producer just like Phineas is, like Billie Eilish's brother, they very similar stuff. And this one of the videos actually uses Phineas and stuff, but I'm going on a tangent. Life Is Not the Same is an incredible track. You need to go listen to it. Just the high moments and the vocal chops, they're just ooh, ooh, ooh. Number 2, Porter Robinson and Totally Enormous Extinct Dinosaurs with Unfold, the final single of the Nurture album. It really felt like a track off of Divinity was. It was just with its wall of sound, and it being at the end of the track list or second last was just a fantastic closer to the album. It was my favorite instantly as soon as I heard it. I just had so much power and energy into the track, and I love the vocal performances from both Porter and Ted there. And number 1, Bowtie's number 1 song of 2021. If you didn't see this coming, well, Tristram with Love Until We Die. The album I gave, the only album I've ever given a 10 out of 10. The song that I loved is honestly, Tristram is part of the reason that this channel exists. He's made up a lot of my viewership and my subscribers on this channel. I covered everything that he did for the album release. And Tristram is very tied to this channel. And I didn't put him at the top of this list because of that, because I feel like I need to. I genuinely love Tristram this much. This song is incredible. It's another one that finishes off the album and encapsulates everything that he was trying to do with the whole first run of the project. And just really man, it's so uplifting. It's cheerful. It's got like a Latin pop feel to it with a kind of nice little stringy guitar. I mean, all guitars are stringy, but you know what I mean? Like plucking of the guitar. It's just such a fun, uplifting, has that more grandiose feel at the end to track. And it has a almost like a slow finale, like a minute finale to it. That is just a great bookend to a fantastic album. And that is my list, the top 50 songs of 2021. Let me know in the comment section below what you guys thought of these songs. Are any of these songs on your guys' top lists? I want to know what your number one song of 2021 was. But with that, I've been Bowtie Media, and I will see you guys in another video.